Parajita, I come to you first. Is this not hugely embarrassing for the Uttar Pradesh government, which so far would have wanted people to believe that they'd done no wrong? The manner in which the judge, and I want to take you through what the judge says, you know, the judge says, would you have allowed for this funeral to take place at night without seeing the body of your daughter if this had been your daughter? You know, the UP ADGP is unable to answer that question. You're coming in for serious criticism, and this whole effort to try and somehow pin the blame on the victim, her victim's family, make it seem as if it's all their fault, all of that coming crashing before the courts. Parajita?
Yes, namaskar.
Namaste.
There is absolutely no reason why the BJP should feel embarrassed by the statements made in the court today. In fact, right from beginning, the Yogi Sarkar has made it in its intentions very clear. We wanted a very impartial inquiry. We wanted justice for the dead girl and her family. And we always tried to ensure that right from the beginning. And that is why a CM went for CBI. In fact, he gave the request and immediately the notification was issued by the MHA. And the SIT was immediately constructed after the incident. And it's extremely good that the judiciary, the Lucknow bench of the Allahabad High Court, has taken cognizance of the matter. All of us want the truth to come out. And let me tell you very clearly that the central government or the Yogi government have made it very clear that the guilty should be punished. Now, whosoever is guilty, whether they are the government servants, in fact, some of the police officials had been suspended in the first 2 days of the crime happening. And not only the government servants, whosoever is the culprit behind this entire dastardly act should be actually nabbed.
Supriya Srinath, the BJP MP argues that yes, the High Court came down hard on government officials, but this is not something the BJP as a political party needs to feel embarrassed or sorry about, because the Yogi Adityanath has said, and it's correct that the Chief Minister has said, that whoever is responsible, the punishment given should be so severe that this becomes a case study for anybody else who ever dares to do something wrong. And therefore, the BJP spokesperson says, you know, it's good that this is happening, and no, we're not sorry about it. We want those who are guilty to be held accountable. Supriya.
I will just say two things simply, Rahul. Just a quick reminder that the BJP is a government in Uttar Pradesh. And when police officials are pulled up, and they have not just said why was she cremated the way she was, they have also pulled up ADG Law and Order Prashant Kumar specifically saying that you are speaking of the old law, the rape law has changed, and you are not making a mention of how semen does not need to be found, and attempt to rape is also rape. With all due respect, who does he report to? He is a part of the UP administration, and the buck stops on this at the chief minister's door. Madam who spoke before me very categorically stated immediate action was taken and the case was transferred to the CBI. No, madam, it was not. It was announced that the CBI will take probe, but the official notification was issued only yesterday. So 8 days after the official notification, the chief minister kept quiet for 15 long days, and some in your party have called the woman filthiest of names. Ranjit Srivastav, your party leader, have said she was, quote-unquote, a loose character woman in Hindi. Somebody from your party has said this was honor killing. Your MP from Chhattisgarh has said that incidents like this happen and this is just balavati ho raha hai. Aisa toh hua hi nahi hai.